one. So you've got.
Cancel out those, right? I got it.
You can really. You can really, so what you can really do there. You can write this as P one five, a big bracket here. Let's write this as row one over ten times. One over row one. That's what the first fraction becomes, which is just one over ten.
Got that.
The second fraction becomes 125 times z one cubed over z one cubed. And then the third one becomes e one cubed over one times.
One half.
Oh, so 25 is wrong, huh?
It's 100.
I forgot the cube. There you go. So it's 125 times 8 divided by 10. 125 times 8. So we have resolved most of our algebra and math calculator difficulties. There. Hope just don't do it like me and don't do it in your head.
Don't erase
it. Okay, our beam intensity has three factors. Proportional to the KVP squared, and it's inversely proportional to the distance squared, and it's proportional to something called the MAS squared. MAS, not squared. All right, given those relationships, what does our formula look like?
I proportional to KVP squared.
me a chance. Right, let's give them a chance to write it down.
God.
And while you're working on that, I'll come up with some
changes. But I might have typed it wrong, no?
No, don't tell me that.
Okay, good. So the 1.5 has to be squared, the 0.75 has to be squared. Simple mistakes, right? All right.
Hold on.
Doesn't it feel great? Oh it feels
God.
Great.
Yes. I have the power.
Yes.
Oh my God. Thank you, Dennis. Oh my God, without you, I wouldn't be here.
Yeah, you would.
I was so lost in the sauce last class, but now I feel good.
I don't like that.
Working with same idea. There's a slight variation on this game, but it's basically we're going to start with the same equation. There's just a slight variation that comes up. And this has to do with the idea that at some point you've got your KVP all set, but you end up having to move the patient a little bit farther away. And you want to keep the intensity the same, so you've got to increase the MAS. And this is that case. So we're keeping the KVP the same. So you can just think of this as disappearing. If KVP2 is equal to KVP1, it goes away. And here's a little twist. You want to keep I2 the same as I1. So what does that make that?
One.
So your new equation says 1 is equal to d2 squared over d1 squared times MAS1 is 2. It looks a little bit different. You want to figure out what is MAS2 compared to MAS1.
MAS2 is
I
go base with this, but.
No,
oh,
yeah,
okay.
I can use the MAS.
Yeah.
1.6.
A D1 square on top?
It is.
So the square is on the outside because it applies to both D1 and 1.3.
It goes to both.
Oh, the very top.
Oh, the very top?
Yeah, but no, it should be D2 square and then change it to
starting from here.
Yeah. Like this.
And then once you plug in that, it becomes D1. But it wouldn't just automatically
be D1.
one less thing, exactly.
Questions,
yeah.
Concerns, issues? Back up a little bit to one of the other streams.
Yeah.
We're back to photoelectric absorption.
Okay.
The densities are going to stay the same. It's going to be the same material. It's going to be the same as E. But the probability of 2 is 10 times the probability of 1. So what is that remaining factor? Photoelectric absorption. I wrote it down about 20 minutes ago, 30 minutes ago.
Energy.
Not the scattering.
Energy.
You did it right after the constant scatter.
Energy.
Yeah. Well, which E is it?
To the third.
EQ, correct. So, there's the E in constant scattering.
Oh, just a plain E.
So P is proportional to
one
over E cubed.
I know that's
gonna really. So question is,
what is V2 that we want?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
V2 cubed. Is that allowed?
What were you writing for me?
That's what I'm hoping you would know.
I don't know. I don't know if I was allowed to do it.
The rest of them.
Okay.
Am I allowed to do that? I don't know.
Yeah.
Is there more to do that?
No, that's it. Except, it seems like the noise is disappearing.
Yeah.
But
I get what you're saying. There's no.
That's probably what you asked me, but I was.
Yeah, but I did the Q group that applied to the E1 as well.
Well, as long as you have cubed inside, then that's still fine.
Okay. So would I? Sorry. Would this be E1 cube root of 1/10?
E1 times the cube root of 1/10, exactly.
Okay. I put.
And what is the cube root of 1/10?
Because I
put
the.
Two and change, right?
I put the E1 over 10 under the cube root.
1/2 would change.
How did you lose the cube?
Oh,
on that?
I get it.
How did I go from here to here?
Yeah.
How did I? Good question. Carefully.
I got 0.46, is that right?
0.64, yeah. 0.46, yeah.
Cool.
Any surprises on getting cube roots? Yeah.
Does it matter if the E1 is 0.46?
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
Right.
Photon energy is there are more questions back there? Got a big group project going on in the back row there. That's fine. Let's try a few others. Back to something that we started off with a while ago, a little bit different, but back where we started off. Photon energy is proportional to frequency. Now you're comfortable with this language. What would you write? Photon energy, E.
E equals F.
Do you remember the equation that really goes with it?
E1/E2
equals F. Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
F2? Yeah?
It's yes. Weird to be so.
But I gave you, in particular, there's this photon equation. Something we did last week. So it's last week, so of course.
Oh, is it Z?
Z, not quite. H.
Yeah.
E is equal to H. F. So how do those two equations compare? How do these two equations compare? In this case, we have an equality. In this case, we have a proportionality. Yeah, in fact, this is called the constant of proportionality. That's really the name of it. It happens to be Planck's constant in this case. So, but when you write it like this, we think of this H as a constant of proportionality. Okay. All right. Remember what H is? Can I erase this yet?
Yeah.
6.626
times 10 to the
-34
joules per second.
And your favorite set of units?
Joules per second.
H and your three sets of units, whichever one you like better. And now I give you the problem. Photon B has twice the frequency of photon A. What is the energy? Do it in a number of ways.
Okay.
You don't actually need to use the H, but you could probably try to find some way to use it if you wanted to. Can't really use the H. It's really more about using the proportions.
photon B has twice the frequency of photon A. How does the energy of photon B compare to photon A? Bada bing, bada boom. The answer is...
Two times more.
It's twice. It's proportional.
I hate this.
Mary.
About a year, 2 years from now, I'm going to fall down and break my wrist, and I'm going to come into your
room.
What is my
wrist?
If I ever need an x-ray in the Bay Area, I'm in trouble.
Don't worry. Just give us all A's, you'll be fine.
Exactly. That's a good one.
Depend on wavelength.
Nope.
There's a lambda. Wavelength is lambda. Right. Wavelength, lambda.
Inversely proportional
to lambda. All right. Okay, so photon B has twice the wavelength of photon A. What is the energy of photon B compared to photon A? You guys are getting fast at this.
Okay.
You're not even having to write it down now.
All right. It's a different story on a test.
It's down the road. Kinetic energy from 2.5 weeks ago. How is kinetic energy related to speed?
Mass times velocity squared.
So when I ask you how is it related to speed, in the language of what we've been doing.
Velocity,
speed, velocity. So it's proportional to?
Kinetic energy.
K is proportional to?
Inverse.
What do I put there for speed? Do we remember the kinetic energy equation?
Yes.
What is it?
One half mv squared.
So what do I write here?
1/2 mv squared.
I don't want the 1/2 of the m.
Oh, it's v squared.
1/v squared directly. Proportional to the square.
Oh.
And what would R in the, you know, the framework of dealing with proportionalities the way we have been?
Yep.
square. Kinetic energy related to mass.
Accept them.
Inverse.
One half.
Oh, it's
one half. Or just in the language of proportionality.
One over m. Oh wait.
M.
M. Right. So if I were to make up the.
Yeah.
M2 is equal to M1 over M2. Well, it's just kind of a fun way to repicture everything and make it all seem related and practice the skill. So remember back when we were doing our photoelectric with all three and then the intensity with all three things? What would you put together considering kinetic energy is related to mass and speed? What I'm asking you, how do you combine them?
Write it. Write it out. I'll tell you if you're right.
E1 squared. Seems almost obvious at this point. Yes? All right. We're supposed to have a test, I think, not next week, but the week after.
Sure.
It's a test.
Yeah, on the 11th.
On the 11th, yes. So we'll, next week we'll start figuring out what's going to be on the test. And we'll do a lot of practice for it. But this was, I think this was a really good detour through all these relationships. All right, stop there. Good. We'll make the rest of the semester easier.
Huh. So,
yeah.
It's going to get easier, right?
Yeah.
Sounded <That's laughs> like a really confident yes.
Okay, so I'll be up at the Learning Center at 3:30 to 4:30.